Hi, Dave Bailey, Team Nutritionist, NIU Football. Glad you're back. Remember where we left off last time? We said, boy, when we don't eat, when we go 3, 4, 5 hours without putting something in our mouths, our body eats itself. Remember, it's that little Hannibal Lecter guy getting let out of the cage, dining on our lean muscle tissue. Bad idea. The other thing that also happens, because our body knows that that's naughty, that we let Hannibal loose and we're eating ourselves, our body says, well, Dave, you didn't give me a choice. You didn't feed me, so I have to do this because I'm really good at surviving. The other thing that happens is our metabolism, let's say it's running this fast. When Hannibal comes out of his cage, now the metabolism starts running really slow because our body knows this isn't a good thing, but I have no choice. I have to do this. So we can all imagine that time that just something's come up. It's been 4, 5, 6 hours since I'm eaten, and oh my, I'm starving. I could eat anything. I don't think many of us, when we got home or to a friend's house, or maybe we met up with some people at one of our favorite eateries, I don't think there's many of us that walk in the door going, boy, I'm so hungry. I hope they've got some Brussels sprouts and liver. Probably not. What do we crave when we get food deprived? We tell the truth. Most of us crave carbs. We want carbs. It's like you walk into somebody's place and you're like, oh my God, half of a Dirgiano's pizza. That's awesome. Or, oh my God, look, there's a bag of ranch Doritos. What do? Boom, too much of some bad stuff. In this case, we spiked our blood sugar and now we're storing fat. And that's how the yo-yo goes, and we do not want that for our football team, and we don't want it for you because we're all a team. Until next time, go Huskies.